The proton pack is not a toy, but we're gonna play with it anyway. What's up, gang? Jamie Hodges here from Report All Ghosts. As of today, we are less than 3 months away from the release of Ghostbusters Frozen Empire, the fourth installment in the Ghostbusters saga, the continuation, the sequel to the follow-up to the Spangler family story, officially seeing the return of the Ghostbusters to the firehouse in New York. As such, and just slightly ahead of the official announcement from Hasbro just next week, we're already starting to see Ghostbusters merch creeping its way onto store shelves. Not only in regards to toys related to Frozen Empire, but also we're finally seeing the recently revealed addition to Kenner's classic Hasbro retro line, the Ghostbusters Fright Features. They're back, baby! And with that, there's a foot in the game. The game is afoot. The hunt is on. That's right, the frenzy for brand new Ghostbusters merch is at an all-time high. Not only in regards to toys, but collectibles in general. We're also already seeing Ghostbusters Frozen Empire Funko Pops showing up at select box launch locations. This week, people are reporting seeing the Frozen Empire and Kenner Classics merch showing up specifically at Target. Now, while this is slightly ahead of Hasbro's official announcement, it's not completely otherworldly, as you have to consider this movie was supposed to come out a few weeks ago, so a lot of this stuff is probably within its street date. And if you haven't seen anything in the wild yet, don't fret, because again, these things start to roll out very slowly. And so we put our boots to the ground, we hit the streets. We got one. Well, we got some. And if you want to make sure that you see that little something, you better point your PKA meters at Report All Ghosts on Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, and here on YouTube. And if you're watching there, you might as well go ahead and like, share, subscribe, and ring that bell. And while that little sum is something that you might see in a future review video, today we're here to talk about one thing. I want to talk about protons and blasting them. I want to talk about proton blasters. That's right, while we did say that we grabbed a few things during our initial toy hunt, the very first thing that we want to talk about here on Report All Ghosts is the new Zap and Trap Proton Blaster from Hasbro and Ghostbusters Frozen Empire. There has been some talk among the community since reveals of this thing hit the net and it started popping up on Amazon and Target websites that this is maybe just a repaint of the previously released Proton Blaster mod from Ghostbusters Afterlife. Well, I'm here to tell you, you're dead wrong! You done messed up, Aaron! That would be incorrect. And to back up that claim, whoop-pow! A double pow! You ever seen a guy handle two wands? We have the original release of the Proton Blaster mod here to take a double take. We're gonna take a look, we're gonna compare the two. But before we do that, we gotta talk about the subject of the day. We gotta talk about the new boy. And before we do that deep dive, you know we gotta do it. I gotta do my most favorite thing. I gotta look at the box. Checking out our chilling backdrop, you can see the firehouse hook and ladder 8 looking a little iced up. Holy Toledo, Batman, is that that drip? And as we are making our official return to the firehouse in New York, you're gonna see a lot of brick and mortar lining the package that reflects that. Brandishing the signature Ghostbusters title and post-afterlife, seeing the return of that classic clean logo. Look at my boy Moogly, looking fresh. Appropriately named the Zap and Trap Proton Blaster, this terrifying toy promises and boasts over 20 supernatural sounds. You're welcome, parents. Flipping it around to the back, you're gonna see a little bit of danger tape because you can't do up Ghostbusters without doing up some danger. Also, with a more detailed look at our new Zap and Trap Proton Blaster sitting at 20 inches, not that big if you ask me, as well as some quick fire instructions on how to operate your new wand. Outside of all those spooky sounds, this thing even lights up, promising a color-changing stream. You blast the rainbow, you taste the rainbow. It even comes with a really cool kids replica of the Ghostbusters Research and Development Department ID tag. We already saw a much more high-detailed replica of that included in the upcoming Hasbro 2-in-the-box 2-set trap PKE meter coming out later this year. So this is a really fun addition and imaginative way for young fans to immerse themselves into the Ghostbusters world. The Proton Pack is not a toy, but we're gonna play with it anyway. You know what that means. It's time to bust this thing open. I'm ready to bust. Bust. Because it feels good. After some quick assembly, including your trigger box and new clear proton stream, you're ready to start zapping and trapping. Now there's a ton of functionality in this little thing, and we're gonna try our best to look at all of it. But first, we gotta talk about the look of this wand, because it's drastically different than the last one, in some pretty cool ways. Now, one thing I boasted about with the original Proton Blaster mod toy is that it gave me a sort of sense of nostalgia. There was something about that powder blue that just reminded me of the toys that I grew up with. This one takes a swing in the completely opposite direction, and maybe to its benefit, because now we're looking at a more film stylized Ghostbusters Proton Blaster children's toy. But I would have been absolutely okay with that as a kid. Now, as I said earlier in the video, this is not the mod wand, and as such, there's some key differences in the look of this thing based on the change in functionality. Some of the major differences are going to include three different buttons now that each do something different on the wand. We also have some brand new film-inspired details on the opposite side, inspired by the actual props adjuster knobs, because we don't have those mod attachments anymore. And that front handle is thick. Since it no longer has that twist function, this is modeled a little bit chunkier to line up with what's seen on the film's prop. This is very obviously modeled for a child's hand. Luckily, child hands. While this front end may be reminiscent of at least one of the attachments seen on the mod thrower, this one is very obviously leaning more towards the shroud we see on the front of the throwers in the new film Ghostbusters Frozen Empire. Now, since they went for a more film-inspired look and painted it black, they did have to include an orange tip, which has some adults upset. Now including a melted glue stick. This is the gunk that comes out when your thing overheats. Also including a brand new clear proton stream to help better reflect some of the really cool light effects inside. And that signature Frozen Empire inspired cheese plate. Now it looks a little bit differently in the actual film, but they obviously wanted to keep this Ghostbusters logo here. So painting the heatsink is a pretty good compromise for a toy. On the note of that Ghostbusters logo, it's not a sticker anymore. This is an actual risen detail, which I think is really cool. Ever since I was a kid, there's nothing I thought was cooler than seeing the Ghostbusters logo on any product. And now I can touch it. It's very tactile. Now, while there are some functional switches on this wand, which we'll get into shortly, there's a lot that don't really do anything, except for these two right by the bar graph, which just that little firm click gives a little bit extra touch to the imagination and playability of this toy. But what good is a wand if you're not gonna use it to zap and trap? Let's get ready. Switch me on. Now, one thing you might notice almost immediately is while that's a pretty standard activation sound, it's definitely different than the classic one that we heard in the Ghost Blaster mod. This one is a little bit more on par than what we've seen in the Spangler wand. So with over 20 plus, now we have a whole new array of supernatural sounds. Now Hasbro does like to hide Easter eggs, so we might not even actually get to hear all of them, but we're gonna try to run through as many as possible as we try to figure out how this thing works. This is training day. We're doing it live. Now, if we follow the box's instructions, there's actually a little bit of a backward sequence as to how this is supposed to work. Starting from the top, we got our call. This is supposed to be the call. Are we getting a call? send some chills down your spine. We gotta charge it. And then you blast them. There's a lot packed into this thing that's straight out of the last movie. But not only that, it also includes some video game sounds. Almost exactly like the Spengler one. For kids. It's for kids. Little baby Spanglers. You remember that episode? 3 Men and an Egon. It's a real episode. It's one of my favorites. But in any case, as a Ghostbusters fan, and just for like extended playability for the younger audience, I think it's awesome to try and include as many sounds and functions into this thing as possible. We've already taken you through the base sequence, but this call button actually switches proton stream modes every time you hit it. You've got your standard proton stream, your boson collider, or maybe you're in the mood to sling some slime. I frosted them. Oh, that was Muncher. That one might have just been another standard proton stream. But still, there's more than enough sounds in here. Some of those ghosts I don't recognize. That was my first time here in Muncher. And there's still a whole rogues gallery of phantasmal foes we haven't been introduced to yet that are probably packed away in this little box. That's really cool. Man, that's hot. Rakow! I want to talk about some of these lights. I don't know if you can hear me over all the protons. The way it catches that proton beam, it's lit. It's litty. When the light hits your beam like a proton linguine, that's a Ghostbuster. I don't speak Italian. Now, any prop maker worth his salt can probably point out a million things wrong with this thrower, but how many things are right? All the way down to the raised clippered logo on the valve here. I talked a lot about nostalgia with the original Proton Blaster mod, but that's just nostalgia. If I had gotten something like this as a kid, my pants would be toast. Now that's only running through some of the sounds that we've found so far. Just like a lot of other Hasbro's props, I imagine the more you play with this thing, the more and more you're gonna discover. Retailing for $29.99, this Ghostbusters Zap and Trap Proton Blaster is worth every cent. Currently showing up at select Target stores and also available on Amazon.com. And we're only 1 week into hunting. As we get closer and closer to the release of Ghostbusters Frozen Empire, I imagine you're going to see so much more of this stuff making its way onto store shelves. We had a pretty successful toy hunt so far, but we ain't done yet. If you want to see more reviews like this, or keep up to date on all the latest leading up to the release of Frozen Empire, you're going to want to make sure to like, share, subscribe, and ring that bell. Until next time, I'm Jamie Hodges, and I'll see you on the other side.